It isn't every day a business celebrates its 50th anniversary. But in June, customers shared the joy of Rhinelander Bakery's milestone in Old Town Arvada.
Businesses like this, it's what makes these small towns thrive, and it gives you a heartbeat to a city like this.
Bakery owners Ed Dimmer and Mauro Dimmer celebrated by giving back with a four-day Bake Out Hunger campaign, earmarking 50% of their sales to go to the Arvada Community Food Bank. Face painting, German music, and a cake cutting ceremony topped off the festivities.
Is this a special day or what? They've been here through some pretty rough times in terms of when Old Town wasn't what it is today. So they've seen the darker side, and they've certainly seen the success that's been happening. And frankly, they're a big part of the reason for the success. And with that, it's time?
It's time.
It's time.
Okay. Woo! Awesome.
Our success is, yes, it's due in part by our own efforts, but it's clearly due in part to the, the passion that the community has for its own history. And so being here for 50 years, you get to see all of that.
Indeed, he has. Ed was just a little boy when his parents settled in Arvada in 1963 after immigrating from Germany years earlier. Ed's dad took over the Arvada Bakery, as it was known then.
He came here and instantly fell in love with the Old Town area. One, it's a two-story structure, so we could both live and work in the same place. A really, really big thing all throughout Europe.
The whole family worked in the business. Mom and Dad baked, and Ed helped too, beginning at age 9.
One of my very first assignments was glazing donuts. So growing up in that kind of a business, I actually had the privilege of speaking to people that founded the city at the time, or were one of the first homesteaders. And it was just absolutely precious.
Reflecting on his 50 years here, Ed recalls that he wasn't always destined for the bakery business. In the 1980s, he went off to college, where he studied chemistry, math, and physics at CU. He met Mauro, who was working on a doctorate related to political science. But their paths led them back to the bakery.
Whenever you get to work with people and you see the joy in people's faces, there is a certain amount of attraction to that kind of a job. And so I definitely wanted to go back. Plus, at that time, I was ready to ask Mauro's hand for marriage.
We took the family business over, and then it was like an amazing progression of moving from a small family business to a business with about 15 employees today. We're very thankful for what we have here.
Over the years, there have been a lot of changes, including an explosion in the variety of baked goods, going from mostly bread and donuts in the 60s to hundreds of unique delicacies today.
We probably had 20 different items in 1963 available, where today, in a year, it comes out to about 1,100 different items.
They've pioneered trends in the bakery business.
We long ago became trans fat free, so we've been that for about a decade. We are also very low sodium.
When Mauro faced cancer in 2001, then celiac disease in recent years, Ed's chemistry background went into high gear in the kitchen.
For a baker, telling them that you don't have gluten or sugar, sugar is a huge bulking agent. Gluten is what allows you to build pockets, and you're going, ah!
But by analyzing ingredients, Ed came up with his own blend of sweetener alternatives and flour products, and now offers sugar-free, gluten-free, and products that are free of both.
Food is a very emotional thing, and for the first time for some people to be able to get a real birthday cake, it just brings some people to tears.
As their business has grown, so has their philanthropy. Their annual King Cakes fundraiser first raised money for Arvada's sister city, Meridian, Mississippi, hit by Hurricane Katrina. Today, that annual fundraiser goes to the Red Cross Society. They've supported the Chocolate Affair and Ralston House and other causes. Their 50th anniversary event will become an annual affair to support the Arvada Food Bank. This year, it raised an amazing $10,570. But mostly, they do what they love best every day.
I've been coming here for 30 years, a long, long time. Yeah, they're great people. Great products, always fresh. So absolutely, you have to celebrate their anniversary, absolutely.
As Ed and Mauro look toward their own retirement, they're planning to ensure Rhinelander Bakery will be here for years to come.
Our staff is really becoming the next soul of the operation. And they are every much into what we do as Mauro and myself. So there's no worries that the business won't be tended to in the future.
And that's really good news to faithful and longtime customers of all ages who've come to enjoy every nibble.